unbelievable prizes. Stadium by me asking them a trivia question. What's your name?
Cindy.
Cindy or Sydney?
Cindy.
Cindy. And Cindy, where are you from?
Texas.
Are you a team bride or team groom today?
Bride and groom.
So say team both?
Team both.
All right, so I'm going to ask you question number one. Lisa and Mark's brother, Pat Schweiss, were born on the exact same day, September 20th of 1966. In what year did they both graduate from high school? Is it A, they never did? Is it B, 1984? Is it C, 1985? Or Lisa did in 84 and Pat did in 85? What is your answer?
I'm going to go with D.
D is the correct answer. Congratulations. And I have for you a St. Louis Cardinals chef apron. How about that? All right, let's walk right over here. What's your name, big boy?
Kevin.
Kevin, where are you from?
Dallas, Texas.
Kevin is from Dallas, Texas. He's representing the Cardinals with his jersey, LSU Tigers with his hat. Let's see how smart he is. First off, are you team groom or team bride?
Team groom.
Team groom. All right, so you might know this question, you might not. When Lisa is out in public, what feature of hers is most often commented on by others? A, her odor. B, her laugh. C, her hair. Or D, her fiance. What do you think is the answer?
D, her fiance.
Well, that's an incorrect answer. I know you would think so, but let's eliminate that one and try another one.
Her laugh.
That's also an incorrect answer. So let's see if you can get one more incorrect of that, leaving the correct one.
Her hair.
Her hair. Ding, 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 ding. That is the correct answer. She's got a really cool haircut, and everywhere she goes, people comment on her hair. You, sir, get a pair of St. Louis Cardinals throwback blue socks. There you go. All right, let's come up here, sir. What is your name?
Brad.
Brad, where are you from?
St. Louis.
Brad is from St. Louis. If you're from St. Louis, make some noise. All right, here we go, Brad. As a junior in college, Mark ran for student government. What first name did he use on the ballot ticket? A, Marky Mark, B, Schwetty, C, Sparky, or D, the Donald? First, let me ask you, are you Team Mark or Team Bride?
Team Bride.
Team Bride, so you might not have any clue, but what are you gonna go with here?
I'm gonna take a guess, C, Sparky.
That is correct, congratulations. I have an awesome prize for you. And check this out. This is a Cardinals floppy hat. There you go. Wear it with pride and cover that dome. We don't want you getting burned today. All right, let's come right down here. What is your name?
Becca.
Becca, you were just sitting there minding your own business, and then all of a sudden, here I am next to you. Are you team bride or team groom?
Groom.
And where are you from?
St. Louis.
St. Louis. All right, here's your question. Which is one of Mark's biggest fears in life? Is it A, water sports, B, complimenting someone, C, running out of licorice, or D, getting married? What will be your answer?
A.
A, water sports is correct. Mark hates the water. He can't even swim. He needs to wear those floaties on his arm if he's even taking a shower, for crying out loud. And you know what I have for you? This Fox Sports, really cute. Hold that up and show everyone what you just got there. Look at her sporting that thing. All right, we have one more before we're running out of time. Let's come all the way down here in the second row. What's your name, sir?
Steve.
Steve, where are you from?
St. Louis.
Have you ever done voiceover work before, Steve?
No.
No, you should. You've got a magnificent voice. Are you team groom or team bride?
Both.
Both. Awesome. So here we go. Mark and Lisa are very compatible because A, Mark is so empathetic. B, Lisa is always politically correct. C, they both like to play dress up. Or D, Mark is losing his hearing.
D.
Let's try it again.
A.
Let's try it again.
B.
Let's try it again.
There's one more.
It's all of them. Hey, give him a big round of applause, everyone. He also gets a pair of Cardinal socks. All right. Are you guys ready to have some fun today? Are you ready to see Mark and Lisa get married today? All right, here we go. When I count to three, I want everyone to yell with me, play ball. One, two, three. Let's do it.
everyone. I am Mark's aunt, and I am honored to be here as part of this important event. By the way, Lisa, I hope you realize that I will be your aunt also. Did you give that some thought when you said yes? I also would like to warn everyone to look at the sky after I promise Mark and Lisa, husband and wife, because the sky may start falling. Might want to run for cover. Welcome, family and friends. We gather here today to celebrate the wedding of Mark Schweiss and Lisa Youngblum. Blood.
Oh. Who's Lisa?
Yeah, who's Lisa? You have come here to share in this commitment they make to one another, to offer your love and support to this union, and to allow Mark and Lisa to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest to them. God bless these hands that you see before you this day. May they always be held by one another. Give them the strength to hold on during the storms of stress and the dark of disillusionment. Keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love. Help these hands to continue building a relationship founded in your grace, rich in caring, and devoted in reaching for your perfection. May Mark and Lisa see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in your name. Amen. Mark and Lisa, you have made a very serious and important decision in choosing to marry each other today. You are entering into a sacred covenant as life partners, knowing that together you must encounter life's sorrow no less than its sweetness, its frustration along with its grace and ease, its disappointments along with its fulfillments. Enter your marriage confident in the love and trust you have already created between you. As you go forward in your journey together as husband and wife, devote yourselves to living according to the vows you share today. Keep your love alive with your openness to each other, your enthusiasm for each other. You hold each other's hearts in the palm of your hands. Be gentle caregivers, honoring this trust. Let this be a marriage that enhances your individuality and allows you to know the greatest gift of God has given us, the ability to love one another and be loved. Is it in this spirit and for this purpose that you have come here to be joined together? If you agree, say yes.
Yes.
At this time, the couple has asked Mark's father, George, to do a reading.
The reading that Lisa and Mark have chosen for their special day is a reading from the Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 16. You are God's chosen race, his saints. He loves you, and you should be clothed in sincere compassion, in kindness and humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with one another. Forgive each other as soon as a quarrel begins. The Lord has forgiven you, now you must do the same. Over all these clothes, keep them together and complete, put on love. And may the peace of Christ reign in your hearts, because it was for this that you were called together as parts of one body. Always be thankful. Let the message of Christ in all its richness find home with you. Teach each other and advise each other in all wisdom. With gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms and hymns and inspired songs to God, and never say or do anything except in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Marriage is the essence of human relationships. It challenges us to be of one accord without abandoning the truth of our individuality. It challenges us not to lose ourselves in one another, but rather to walk side by side, heading in the same direction. As with all relationships, marriage is an endless presentation of choices about how we want to be with each other. Each choice results in either more unity or more separation. Choose that unity, Mark and Lisa, every chance you get. Share the gifts of your friendship, humor, vulnerability, sensitivity, and kindness. Be sure to find ways each day to protect, affirm, and support each other, and to treasure the balance and shared value that you have found with each other. I wish you the courage to keep your loving hearts open to each other for the rest of your lives. God bless you. At this time, Mark and Lisa have written their own vows for this very special moment as they enter into the covenant of marriage.
Lisa Marie Youngblood, my brown-eyed, sassy girl, since we took that leap of faith 3.5 years ago, you have simply rocked my world. You are passionate, you are funny, you are sexy, you are energetic, you are smart, you are mysterious, you are intellectual, you are passionate, you are confident, you are spontaneous, you are adventurous, you are happy, you are sweet, you are loving, and oh, did I say that you're passionate? But most of all, Lisa, you are my friend, you are my lover, and you're my biggest advocate. Not a day goes by that we don't get in a heated conversation about something totally meaningless. As you converse, your eyebrows raise, you'll use hand gestures, facial expressions, your eyes will move side to side, never really making eye contact with me. Along the way, you'll mix in a few of your unique laughs. You'll essentially work yourself into a total frenzy. It's during these moments, Lisa, and this happens every single day, that you've got me. You have once again captured me into your web of intrigue, into this web that is you, and only you. I simply find myself mesmerized by your passion, your zest for life, and I can't break free. I don't want to break free. I just want to keep coming back for more and more and more. The words, until death do us part, and I repeat, until death do us part, used to scare the bejesus out of me. I am no longer afraid. Lisa, may I be so lucky as to someday die in your loving arms, knowing that we have lived a full life together, knowing that we have always challenged each other to become better people, knowing that we have always loved and supported each other no matter what obstacles are in our way, and knowing that along the way, we have laughed a lot and never taking each other too seriously. Today, Lisa, I give myself to you unconditionally.
Well, Sparky, we are quite the love story. After years of friendship, we took an against all odds chance at love, which, by the way, is the best decision I've ever made. I fell in love with you the moment of our first kiss. It was as if you'd cast a spell on me. And our time together since, that moment has been the happiest of my life. Our family and friends here today have witnessed many of the reasons I love you. My favorite being your witty and often sarcastic sense of humor. You make me smile and laugh every single day. You live life to its fullest, whether we're hiking the Sedona Red Rocks or here in these stands cheering on the Cardinals. You've made my life a never-ending adventure. You challenge me and inspire me. I feel so lucky that you've chosen to share your love with me and that I get to go grow old with you. I knew we were destined for each other the day I read the first poem that you wrote for me, entitled Love's Arrival. Maybe it was a premonition, as today I get to choose you, my best friend, for my husband. And while I am no poet, like yourself, I hope my favorite passage from E.E. Cummings will do. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my sweet. I want no world, for beautiful, you are my world, my true. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart.
Thank you, Lisa. I'm going to go off script here. Wouldn't be a party unless Mark Schweiss did something totally spontaneous and crazy, and sometimes politically incorrect. Many of you know that I secretly taped our engagement last fall, and I had a blast doing the whole videoing and whatnot. And do you think for a minute that I have access to a Jumbotron and I'm not going to take advantage of that? So Lisa, you will soon be watching my first music video. And nobody knows about this video except for the Cardinals and myself. And it's our favorite song. You will know it because it's a popular song. But the song is perfect. It explains how Lisa makes me feel every single day. So without further ado, I dedicate this video to Lisa. I promise I will not quit my day job. But I also promise that you guys are going to love it. So roll it.
Touching the ground like a heartbeat skipped by.
Oh, if I knew the way out of here, I'd run with these rings. I'm sure they cost like $200 or something, oh, right?
Big spender.
Okay. Bless, O Lord, the giving and receiving of these rings. May Mark and Lisa abide in your peace and grow in their knowledge of your presence through their loving union. May the seamless circle of these rings become the symbol of their endless love. Mark. Your nieces. Mark, as you place this ring on Lisa's hand, repeat after me. Lisa, I give you this ring.
Lisa, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
In the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lisa, repeat after me. Mark, I give you this ring.
Mark, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Mark and Lisa would like to do their unity glass ceremony at this time.
It is now time for our unity ceremony. Many times a unity ceremony only includes the bride and groom, but because Lisa and I have such wonderful parents and Lisa's kids are so important to us, we felt very strongly that we needed to include them as well. You will be hard-pressed to find greater parents than our parents. We have simply been blessed. I don't know if you heard during the announcing of the starting lineups, but Lisa's parents have been married for 55 years, and my parents have been married for 62 years. Well, they're over here. They're over here. It is simply amazing the similarities between these four people. All four of them love their spouses, their children, their grandchildren, and their extended families unconditionally. All four of them would give the shirts off their backs for their loved ones. As a child, it is hard to put in words how comforting it is to know that no matter what the situation, you can always turn to them when you are in need and they will be there for you. They are truly inspiring and perfect examples of what a healthy, happy, loving marriage should look like, and Lisa and I plan on modeling our marriage and our lives in a similar manner.
While Mark does not have children of his own, he has opened his heart and home to my two beautiful kids. Words cannot describe the intensity of a mother's love for her children. I cannot imagine a world without them in it. They are the greatest sources of joy in my life and an inseparable part of me. They will now become part of our new blended family, and I want to thank you, Mark, for sharing with them your kindness, patience, and compassion. Before each of you will be a vial of glass crystals. Each represents the caring love and support you've given us throughout our lives. We ask that in unison, we will pour our glass crystals into the larger vase in the center of the table. As a glass from each of us is blended together, it symbolizes the joining of our separate lives into one union, the beginning of a journey as husband and wife, and one new family. This combined glass will be taken by an artist and blown into a beautiful sculpture, never to be separated again. This new sculpture will be a physical reminder of our beautiful family and the love and commitment we vowed here today. So if our parents could come up and join us.
Tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest. And nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. Cannot wait, I'm yours. One big family, and it's our God-forsaken right to be loved, love, 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 love. So I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm sure there's no need to complicate our time. Our faith.
Mark and Lisa, you have declared your intention and vows before God in this gathering of your friends and family. May the grace of this day carry forward with you all the days of your lives. May you find delight in each other, and may your love continue to grow and to nurture you throughout your lives. There's no crying in baseball. I wish you the strength to be true to your vows you have made here today. May you always have the wisdom to cherish the precious love you share. May you abide by the laws of spirit, nurturing yourselves and this marriage with acceptance, understanding, cooperation, and loving. May the love you share be peaceful, healthy, and filled with blessings and joy. Mark and Lisa have joined together in holy wedlock. Witness the same before God in this company of friends and family, given their love to each other, and declared this love by the giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me, by the state of Missouri, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Mark, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
All right. They're married, everybody. Because of all the love that you feel in the stadium right now, we're going to do our own kiss cam. So when you see yourself on the screen, kiss the guy or gal next to you. We're going to start with the bride's parents. You're on kiss cam. Kiss. Oh, it's taking off the hat and everything. All right. How about the groom's parents? Kiss. Oh. It's a family show. Right here, you two, kiss. You two, kiss. Let's come down here. And who up there? Who's gonna kiss? Stand up. Who wants to kiss who they're next to? Stand up, we'll put you on. Let's go. Right here, these two Cardinal fans right here. Cardinal fans right there. Go ahead and kiss. Who else wants to do it? Over here, kiss cam. Go ahead. We've got a few more. All right, stand up and kiss up there on the right. That couple there in the middle. You guys are up next. How about you two right there? And now you two go ahead and stand up. You two there. How about this guy right here? I want him to take his shirt off. How about those two in the Cardinal jerseys? All right, up top, there's four of you all at once. Three, two, one, go. That's a double kiss. Let's do a few more. Anyone over here in this area? Stand up and do it. Minnesota Twins fans getting after it in the back row. Right here. Right here, those four. And then let's do that whole section. When I count to three, this whole section, just start making out. One, two, three. Once again, give it up for Mark and Lisa, everybody. If you're part of the wedding party of the bride and groom, it's time to get your game on. And you know what that means. You've got the jerseys on the back of your chairs. Put them on. All right, everybody stand up and start doing your rally towels in the air.
This is your celebration.
Celebrate good times, come on.
Let's celebrate.
All right, so congratulations, Mark and Lisa. Listen up, everyone. When you exit Busch Stadium, you're going to form a big pep rally archway in between here and patio. So when you walk out, someone will be out there to instruct you what to do. Again, halfway between Busch Stadium and patios, you're going to form a big archway, and Mark and Lisa are going to run through it. One last time, give them a big round of applause. They just got married today.